Yo, greetings! This is Garth R.S., the Tireless Adventurer, with another episode of FTB Season 3. Episodes of Heaven! Today is going to be 99% or 90% or 93.7% creative, and the rest of it is going to be a little bit of doing stuff that's technical, which is not kind of creative, and I'm going in the wrong direction. Again, you guys get me all turned around. Sure, God, you do. Anyways, at the end of the last episode, after my salutation, I swam out here, and I put down the beginnings of what my platform is going to look like, to which I am going to add the quarry. But before we get going, I need to not get stuck in the doorway. How does one get stuck in the doorway? What the heck was that? That was crazy. It sounded like I killed a zombie when I did that. That was lunacy. Well, since my blue lines extend into the ocean, I figure it would be a good time to introduce this block. The angel block from Extra Utilities. Piece of obsidian, two fezels, and a piece of gold. Bloop. This is one of, I believe, the only block that you can place in Minecraft that doesn't have to be up against something. I can just boop, and it goes right there. And then when you left-click it, it goes right back in your hand. That's just how we do. That's how we do. So, and this is going to help us get out there and put our other two landmarks up without going all the way down to the bottom of the ocean and pillaring. Don't even look at me. You're looking at me. I could feel it. Anyways, don't. Anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to basically swim out. I'm going to do this right here first. That way I can get up on this platform once I need to. But basically, now what I'm going to do is swim out to here, the end of this blue line, place down my angel block, put a piece of cobble on top of it, and then put the landmark on it. Blue, blue, I'm swimming. As you can see, it's pretty deep here, so pillaring would have taken a while. Not so deep here. Well, that's pretty good, but it still would have taken a while because it's ridiculous that way. So let's go ahead and go all the way out to here. And then put that there. And boom, like that. And we put our landmark right there. And then we left click this thing. It goes back into our inventory. And we can get rid of the rest of these. Because we don't like cobble floating out of the middle of nowhere. That's crazy. But we do like it, actually. It's one of my favorite things. Cobble floating in the middle of nowhere. Like, where you been all my life, cobble? Floating in the middle of nowhere. I'll tell you where you been. Doing other stuff. When nobody else was around. Just you and me. Now, I did say that I was going to tell you who told me to do the water drop in the last episode, but I totally forgot. I said, I'll tell you in a few seconds, and then I just didn't tell you. So as soon as I get to a point where I'm not swimming anymore, I'll go over there and do it. So remind me, so I don't forget again. Because I don't like forgetting. Oh, I don't want to forget. I don't want to forget. Let me go right here. Put a piece of cobble right there. And a piece of cobble right there. And a piece of cobble right there. And put our other landmark down. And then we go, bloop, in my hand. And see, no matter what happens, it doesn't fall when you break it. It falls into your inventory. And I did say that I was going to do this, so let me go ahead. Let me go ahead and do it now. Boom. Okay. So he said, hey, Garth, if you want a quick descent into your mine, dig out two blocks at the bottom in front of your ladder and fill it with water. Then jump. It's a quick, safe descent. I do it with all my mine shafts. That was Eldros 5 who said that. And he also said bomb pop and smooth stone slabs for the roof might give a neat slate stone look. And I thought to myself, that would actually be kind of interesting. I think I'd like to see how that looks. And I got to tell you, in my mind's eye, I'm thinking that might be the way to go. However, I do like the steeped roof with the angles. So, look at this. It's a thing. from Thaumcraft. Boop, boop, boop. R node. Anyway, I do like that. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to incorporate that smooth stone half slab. I think that will totally... I got an idea for how it's going to look, and I think I like it. I think I totally like it. So what am I so afraid of? I don't know. But the angel block will help you do a lot of things. Like when you're building, it works well. Okay, so first thing we need to do is right-click this. And it turns into that. And we're like, dude, that's amazing. And we take our quarry, and we go... Apparently, we plop down our quarry and crash the game. So... Can I wrench this up? I cannot, so I'm going to have to do this. But I dropped the quarry, and the game just said kapoop. And it might have been because that was that way. Let's try it one more time. And see if we crash. 3, 2, 1. No, we didn't crash that time. Did we? Yeah, no, we didn't. Okay, so we're good. So basically, 64 by 64 is the limit of what this thing can do. And you're thinking to yourselves, okay, now that we got that, what do we do? Well, here's what we do, my friends. We take this and we put it on top. And we are done. See you tomorrow. No, I'm just kidding. That's totally not at all what we do. And then the next thing that we do is we take our 4 oak barrels and we put them 1, 2, 3, 4, just like that. And I realize I need a longer thing here. So let's go out. Not that way, stupid thing. And we'll pick this back up. That's not a pick. That's a bucket of water. And after the 4 oak barrels, we put down our trash can. And after the trash can, we put down 1, 2, 3 of those. So we should be good as far as that goes. There's fluid. Where's my item ducks? So we come over here. And we go U. You, 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 and you, and you, and you. That is all the item ducts that we're going to need. And then we take a servo and put it on this one and this one. Now we're going to need cobble. And we're going to need dirt. And we're going to need sand. Dirt and sand. And maybe some gravel. There we go. So we got dirt and sand. Now we got to go see if we can locate some gravel real fast. Just so we can set that up. Because we're definitely going to need to set that up. And as the items come out of the chest, the very first thing they'll hit will be the cobble, and then the dirt, and then the sand, and then the gravel. And then they'll hit the garbage can. So it's first come, first serve kind of thing. So we go in there. And it'll drop off everything it gets. If it doesn't have any room for cobble, it'll send it on. And the very next inventory available to it would be the garbage can. But I'm going to whitelist only those items in there. So we shouldn't run into anything else. We got dirt. We got sand. Let me grab a couple more sand. And a couple more dirt, as a matter of fact. Couple more dirt. There we go. And I eat some bread. Perfect. As you can see, it'll totally start working here soon. The sun's coming down, but I don't give a crap because I'm invulnerable. I have super mega armor of awesome toot on, and I've got a bow with no arrows and a sapphire sword. I mean, what more could any human being or Minecraft player possibly need /want/desire? Shut your mouth. You mew way too much. Mewing, which is like what a cat does, I guess, so that's technically incorrect. And what we're going to do is we are going to come out right here. Give me that lever. And we are going to put our aqueous accumulator right here. Like that. We're going to put a fluid duct here and here. And then we're going to put our steam dynamos here and here. And this is going to go here and here. And here and here. And then we're going to go here and here. And then we're going to put down these. Just like that. And basically we're going to have in the top, out the bottom. In the top, out the bottom. And I'm going to set some stuff here for that. But once we get, because I got a little bit going on right here, I just need to turn it into some charcoal. But these four will run, powering this, which can accept a good deal of power. Let's go ahead and slap this down right there. And now we need to set this one up to ignore redstone and just pump everything out. Blacklist nothing. And then in here, we're going to whitelist dirt, gravel, sand, cobble. So once these fill up, they will no longer take anything else. And then the dirt, sand, make sure I got this whitelisted. Whitelist. All right, so it'll allow dirt, gravel, sand, and cobble in here. And then everything else will go down into these three iron chests, which totally works for me. And I totally can't believe I forgot the freaking charcoal. I totally meant to totally do that. Totally. But the good news is, we get to make the run home with all the enemies running amok. Shh. You hear it? No, you didn't hear it. You didn't hear it. Yeah, as soon as we get done with this, which I'm already like 10 minutes in, but we're going to do some creative stuff. And I think what I'm going to do is do a quick design. Ooh, don't even look. Don't look. Let's go over here. There's all kind of monsters outside. I don't even want none. Don't want none. There we go. Sleepy. There you go. Sleepy time. Shh, it's okay. Just go limp. Yeah, go limp. Let's do that. And I have no idea why I came down here. I totally meant to go outside. There's a creeper. What the heck you got on your head? Australian minecart. That's down under. Oh, what's the matter? Are you unsatisfied with your... Are you unsatisfied with your purchase? Get out of here, all of you. Get out of here, I said. Trying to play the Minecrafts. These guys are jerks. Bunch of big, fat, jerky faces. And then we'll see it in action here momentarily. Yes, totally. See it in action. Momentarily. Now, I didn't swim out there and get my landmarks, but honestly, redstone torch and piece of lapis lazuli, I'm not too concerned about it. I should have been, because I'm a bad person. I mean, that landmark was like, when's he coming and come and get me? I'm going to despawn soon. And I'm like, I don't care, you stupid face. I didn't really call him a stupid face because that would be a jerk move. All right, so we'll put that in there first of all. Come over here and put this one in there. And then we take these two extra ones and we put them in the very end just in case it runs out of juice before we can get everything up and running. Now, as soon as it starts generating power, you'll see it starts working. Bump, bump, ba-dum. Now, as you guys recall, I'm using the 400 RF per tick, which is maybe a little wasteful. But these produce 80 RF per tick. So that's pretty good. Now what I definitely need to do is to come over here and probably put like a hoppered barrel of wood on either one of these. Shouldn't be an issue. But here in probably in about maybe 5 minutes, it'll start mining. Because it, as you can see, it goes pretty quick with effectively 160 RF per tick. Not too shabby. We just got to get a whole bunch of wood into here, which is not going to be an issue. It's not going to be an issue at all. And once I get like ender chests, I can get rid of these redstone furnaces, and I can just have an ender chest constantly pumping charcoal into them, which is not an issue. And I'm not going to make you guys sit here and watch this for 5 minutes. I'll be back in a second. Looks like it's finishing. And soon we'll get the little arm, and it'll start doing its minicating. It's already green. Don't sneak in here, little girl. There we go. All right, now it's going to start.
Let me have a question.
You have a question? All right, I'll be right back. All right. So this is not pumping out. Oh, I remember why. I didn't make this the red. So now this should start pumping out. You'll see, yeah, you'll see it land in the sand. There you go. There's 40. As it's picking up stuff, it goes from the highest point to the lowest point. So it dug out here until it got something over there, and then it'll come back over. Let's see. What are we getting now? We get anything cool yet? Nope. We got some clay balls. As you can see, there's not space for clay balls in any of these. So clay balls should appear in here shortly. And some more dirt. Better not be going in the garbage can. There you go. Clay balls. And that's effectively what I do. This is how I quarry without an ender chest. And then I just come over here as needed and retrieve my items. And as you can see, it works. It works well. And having all this stuff in a barrel, you're like, oh my God, you got all this stuff in a barrel? How are you ever going to fix that? How are you ever going to work that out? I'm pretty sure there's a dolly. No. What's it called? Cart? I figured out. Give me a second. It was factorization. There we go. So we go in here. Here, mods, factorization. There we go. That's it? There used to be a dolly where you could move things. Oh, that's inconvenient. Oh, this page two. Where's it at? Where is it at? Oh, I sure do hope they have the dolly. That would be really inconvenient if they didn't. Worst case scenario, just dump it out in my inventory. Not a big deal. It'll take a bit, but that's it. Other than that, see, I already got two stacks of that. Let's see, else do we have anything? Just four clay. We may or may not get some clay from this. But anyway, so let's get on with the creative side of this episode, because we're already like 17 minutes into the episode. But, yeah, I had the idea. So I've got some smooth stone cooked up. We'll give it a shot. Basically, what I'll do is I'll go ahead and I'll cut the video and get everything I have. And then once I have it all ready, get everything I need. Once I have it all ready, I'll come back. Now, this is going to come into play because it's, like, pretty awesome. I like it. You know, click in your inventory, click out your inventory. Boom, boom, boom. It's done. I like it. All right, so give me about 5 minutes. Your time, it'll be like nothing. I think I've made that joke about 1,000 times now, but I enjoyed the crap out of it, so I'll continue to make it. All right, so I believe I got most of what I need. I got some more smooth stone cooking up so I can make this stone bricks. But for all intents and purposes, I do believe we are good to go. So we come down here, this last little bit, I need to come over here and shift to hopefully not fall off. All right, so there is that. That is there. Okay, that's good. That's exactly what I was looking for. Wanted to make sure I had this right, because you got to make sure your stuff is correct. You know what I'm saying? It's got to be correct. Oh, that really, really wasn't a good idea. That reminds me of why I had the angel block in my inventory. No more falling for the roofs. Just dial 1-800-ANGEL-BLOCK. Blink, blink. Let's go right. Actually, I probably didn't even really need it. I keep thinking that's a creeper down there. Yeah, this is the fun part of building right here. You're witnessing it, people. I always make dirt scaffolding because it's easiest to clean up. You can clean it up with a torch. Sometimes I make sand, but it doesn't usually stay where I want it. That didn't work. You drive me crazy already over here. You got to point at the very bottom. And you come across this way. The stone slab idea I've already forgotten who it was. Eldros gave me, instead of just using like a stone slab roof, because I didn't want it to look too cropped at the top, you know what I mean? But he did give me a pretty good idea of how I could make it look nice. And that would be to trim it with that, because the contrasting lighter stone color would be pretty nice, I think, personally. Just me. So I decided to bring the rooftop up to that same level over there, and then to trim around the underside and the upper side with the stone slabs. I think that would be ideal. Boop, boop, boop. And I made lots of stairs, so I'm going to have lots of stairs left. But once I get the roof done, then we should be good to go. This section right over here is going to be open. But the rest of the house is going to have a ceiling. And now I need to go back downstairs and get the rest of that stone bricks that I've been cookering. Can't get down the hole. Hello. Gammy. And gammy. Perfect. And I might want to throw a couple more in there for cookering. Let's put you in there because I got to make stone slabs as well. And that's where the angel block will probably come in handy, because I'll need a roof or something to stand on. And I still can't get rid of that last two little buckles of XP. I have no idea why. I think what I'm going to do to eliminate that problem is probably empty my inventory and my XP and then just kill myself to death. In my opinion, that would probably be the best way to solve that problem. Ooh, that was close. I almost fell off of there. I got to do one more level. I thought I was done. But I was not. And as you guys can see, this coming together, it does take a little bit of shape. Pretty well, as a matter of fact. You know, I was thoroughly enjoying the creative side of this. Coming up with a good design. This house does look a little bit square, but what I tried to do on the inside was to break up the squareness and give it kind of like, you know, uneven shaped rooms and stuff like that, so that you don't have that boring, you know, four walls kind of thing on the inside. Like, you can actually see I made the upstairs an L shape with a pretty large little patio area that's not really going to even serve a purpose other than for aesthetics. That's pretty much it. So what we'll do right here is this is where we'll start the cap with the stone slabs. I think that would probably look nice. And then we can bring them across here on the top row and then over here on the bottom row and then match it over there so that it kind of looks like a smooth stone cap. And then along the underside of here, I'll put a row of smooth stone slabs underneath of it, almost like a little gutter lining. Does that make sense? Probably not, but it'll make sense once I show you, because my brain is much better at having ideas than expressing them. I don't think I'll need to come back up here, but if I do, I'll probably need a way to get back up here. So let's just go ahead and pop this one off. There we go. That'll totally work. And I make the ceilings the way I do because I can, so that way I can fall and not take a preposterous amount of damage. 33? You guys take forever to kook. I'll take it. That should do it right there. And then we'll come back up here in a little bit and get the rest of those. But I'm going to need a whole bunch more. But I'm just going to do the outside now so you can see, and then I'll just fill in the inside later. But yeah, the ceiling is going to go up to the ceiling out here. So these walls will go all the way up to the ceiling out here. And in here, there'll be a ceiling. And then there'll probably be storage up here. You know, like an attic or something. I'll put like a little ladder over there to get up into the attic. It'll be nothing, but it'll still be cool. And what I'm talking about this way. Just like this, all the way across. There we go. And then cap it again, thusly. This way. I think it'll look nice when it's all filled in. Because these slabs will be on the bottom section of this block right here, or the top section right there, they will not allow spawning. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Need to get right up underneath that. There we go. You gotta lay the bottom layer first. This is the top of the square. And then the other one, of course, be the bottom. Excuse me. There's no need for you to be that stupid loud. Just like that. And this will be, effectively, what the trim will look like all the way around. Does that make sense? Hopefully it does. We'll get out from the outside and we'll look at it and see how it looks. What's up, girl?
I've seen my high heels.
Have I seen your high heels? I probably threw them away because they make you look too old. I didn't really do it. I don't know where they're at, sweetie. I haven't worn your high heels in a couple of months.
You wore my high heels?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I just want to know that. Oh, God.
I don't know where they're at, sweetie. God. Which ones are you talking about?
My new black ones.
Duh. Why are you so mean to me? I'm the best dad in the world, and you're mean to me all the time.
Hey, don't blame me, it's fun.
Don't blame you because it's fun. That's the worst excuse ever. Get out of here. I don't know where your stupid high heels are. She's mean. You guys heard that? I got witnesses. Anyway, so let's go ahead and fill this in and see what it'll look like from the outside. And from the outside. From the outside. I need to come outside, not inside. I think it looks nice, but like I said, we still got to put the... Well, first of all, we have to get rid of the dirt gutter. And that freaking scared the crap out of me again. Like a little conniption fit. Shut up. Stupid thing. There you go. What do you got? Nothing. That's what... I think it looks pretty nice. It's like a little Amish hat. What do you think? Amish hat for the win? Get rid of that dirt thing. And I got also get upside down stairs here so that it looks a little more natural. But yeah, we could totally do that. Totally do that. So give me your feedback on what you think the roof looks like. And I do so enjoy feedback. Don't get a lot of it, but I really do enjoy it. It makes me happy. And I love to be happy. It's my favorite thing in the whole wide world besides pizza. Pizza is the bomb. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and throw a few torches up here so I don't get friggin' Spawny McSpawnersons all over the place. And I'll talk to you turkeys next time. And in the interim, be thinking, please. what you'd like to see as far as the creative side goes and what you'd like to see as far as the technical side goes. Because I'm excited to do it for you, just as you're excited to have it done for you. So let's do this, people. Together, I'm trying to motivate you with powerful language. Need dirt, stat, for salutation. Dirt, stat, salutation. Dirt, stat, salutation.
Almost done?
No, I'm not almost done. I'm going to record forever.
Really?
No, get out of here. I'll come in there and play games with you in a second. She called me a meanie. Anyways, yeah, I'll talk to you guys later. Ugh, a second, something in my way. The more ground! What do you guys want? Get out of here! Stop it! There's a cow hammering on my door right alongside with him. He's like, this is fun! I love banging on doors! Let's go downstairs and get rid of these noisy neighbors because they're a bunch of jerk faces. Ow! You're stupid! Get out of here! Why did you fall down on that dirt block? Oh my god, you picked up his flesh! Dude, where did you guys come from? Is there like a convention in town or something? Is there like a convention in town? What's going on? Alright, that's ridiculous. You guys just go on out of here, crazy, loud, noisy neighbors. I hate you!
You get out of my yard! Stupid kids! Causing problems all the time! Crazy.
I like your hat. It's very nice. No, I'm not just being facetious. I really do like it. I think it's extremely, extremely nice hat. Okay, you're welcome. I compliment your hat, and you come over and put scuff marks all over my door. Why you gotta be a big fat jerk about everything? I just told you guys, I don't want any. I'll teach you a valuable lesson in economics. I don't even know what that has to do with economics, but you're gonna learn a lesson in economics, my friend. You hear that? That's the sound of pain. Yeah, I know, right? I'm totally coming. Come on in. Come on in. A little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little bit of whiff ball bat. What you got? Come on. No. It's okay. Hot dog hat. Everybody sucks. You're all jerk faces. Come on. There you go. A little bit of that right in your face. What do you think of it? And I heard you were out here banging on my door, too, so I just wanted to teach you a valuable lesson. But you didn't get a lesson in economics. You got a lesson in death. What do you think? Exactly. Perfect. Let's continue recording forever and ever and ever because freaking neighbors are loud and they suck. They're sucky, loud neighbors. Stupid neighbors with their loud stuff. Just gonna clear this away because it's stupid. I don't like it anymore. This dirt trim was the stupidest idea I ever had. Hey, that's my grass block! Where'd you go? That's my grass block. Get back here. Freaking jerk. Did I get my grass block? I did not. You stupid Enderman. Freaking hate him. Being stupid. Stealing my grass block. I needed that. Wherever it was important. God. Eat some bread. Put an angel block in the sky and put some bricks on it. It's not gonna wait. fat stupid jerk. Stupid fat jerk. Don't like you. Because you're stupid. Fat jerk. Still a grass block. I don't even know anymore. Gonna be breaking windows. I'm so mad. I hate you. Stupid fat jerk. Stole my grass block. God. I don't even know. Stupid. It's mine. It's my grass block. Stupid. My grass block. I put that there. You can't take it. It's against the law. You're a criminal. Criminal. I don't even know. I don't even know. Anymore. Or less. Suck my XP! I don't even know. Talk about your bonus footage. Stole my grass block, man! Grass block! Mine! Boom. Fix the XP problem. Shut your mouth. Goodbye.